Hi everyone, it's Emmett from Pie My Life Up. In this video, we'll be checking out the top Raspberry Pi projects from our website for April 2025. This month's projects covers a wide range, from building a NAS to experimenting with AI or reviving an old printer. If you like the idea of any of these projects, be sure to check out the links in the description below. The first Raspberry Pi project that we are covering is Open Media Vault. This software has continued to be one of the most popular solutions for the Raspberry Pi for turning it into a NAS. Its popularity comes from how easy it makes the entire process. It allows you to create and set up network storage with just a few short clicks in its very intuitive web interface. It saves you the hassle of having to set up Samba shares and messing around with a variety of different options yourself. While the Raspberry Pi isn't the most powerful device, it can still be a decent little NAS, especially when you don't need to maintain speed under heavy load. Being such an energy efficient little device, the Raspberry Pi can easily be set up as a very easy to move around storage hub. Next on our list is LiteLLM. This project enables you to turn your Raspberry Pi into an AI proxy. Essentially what this allows is for you to run multiple models through the single AI endpoint. It is the perfect companion project for those who are running Open Web UI, as it allows you to access more than just ChatGPT. It achieves this by running everything through the single API that replicates how ChatGPT works. The Raspberry Pi makes an amazing device to use as a proxy because it is very low powered, which means it's cheap to keep running 24/7. In addition to working as a proxy, LiteLLM also gives you the ability to log, rate limit, and even implement failovers for your AI models. Up next is turning your Raspberry Pi into a wireless print server. This is one of our classic Raspberry Pi projects that is still a favorite amongst our users. It allows you to bring additional functionality to perfectly good printers that are just lacking some of the more modern conveniences, such as the ability to print over the network. By setting up cups and connecting your printer using a USB cable, you'll be able to easily print from your printer using any device. You can even easily add AirPrint to this server so that you can easily print from Apple devices. You could even get away running this project on one of the smaller Raspberry Pis, such as a Raspberry Pi Zero. The advantage of using the Zero range for this is that they use even less power and are incredibly small, so it's easy to hide it with your printer. Up next is a Raspberry Pi project that can help convert your machine into a retro gaming console. Ever since the original Raspberry Pi, people have always been trying to work out how it can easily be converted into a gaming console. This whole process has become incredibly easy over the years, and one of the best ways to achieve it is using Bossera. Bossera is a distribution that can run on the Raspberry Pi that converts it into a retro gaming console. It provides support for numerous different retro gaming systems straight out of the box and has one of the easiest to use interfaces. It even works very well with controllers such as the Xbox and PlayStation ones. If you plan on turning your Raspberry Pi into a gaming console using this project, we highly recommend using something like the Raspberry Pi 5, as the additional performance it provides will make huge differences. However, if you only want to run Game Boy games, you could even get away with using a Raspberry Pi Zero and a small screen. The final top Raspberry Pi project that we'll be covering for this guide is modernizing your UPS with NUT. NUT stands for Network UPS Tools and is an incredibly cool piece of software. If you have a UPS set up in your house, you'll probably notice that it only has one single USB connection. Now, if you're like us and have multiple devices running off of the single UPS, you'll probably want more than just one, being able to tell when the UPS is on battery power. This is where NUT and a Raspberry Pi comes into play. NUT is capable of getting the battery information, the status of your UPS, and then providing it through an open API. So setting this up on a Raspberry Pi is a great solution, as the Raspberry Pi consumes very little power. So if you go into battery mode, you don't have to worry about your UPS driving even faster than normal. You then set up clients on your other devices that talk to your Raspberry Pi and get the battery information. This enables you to automate things such as safe shutdowns. Since NUT is such a lightweight piece of software, you could even get away with using something like the Raspberry Pi Zero. However, in our case, we use our older Raspberry Pis that we have sitting around, such as the original Raspberry Pi. That's it for our top 5 Raspberry Pi projects of April 2025. If you like this series, be sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe to see more. Until next time, have a good one.